Hey everybody, I'm Jordan Matheson. I'm a program manager on the Visual Studio for Mac team at Microsoft. And today I'm going to take you through our new Visual Studio 2022 for Mac and the latest Preview 3 release that we just put out. So this is our release. It now has support for .NET 6, C Sharp 10, and really big focus in this release for us is on updating the IDE to have a much more comfortable feel for developers, presumably like yourselves, who like to work on a Mac. And so we've focused heavily on the UI of the IDE, moving it to a fully native macOS UI. Now, if you've been with us for a while in Visual Studio for Mac, the IDE has been a combination of UI technologies that were native macOS UI, as well as a cross-platform toolkit that we used to use. And beyond that, that could lead to some experiences that didn't feel quite Mac-like, certain things like some tabs feeling off or just little controls that didn't feel quite right. So this was a big opportunity for us to go ahead and revisit those and do it right to get this nice, comfortable feel for being a Mac-native application. And so along with that, it also gave us an opportunity to go and fix a number of UI glitches that have been in the IDE for a while, as well as smooth out the experience for you. So a big thing you'll notice will be this UI responsiveness, things like resizing windows. Generally moving around the IDE should feel snappier. So that was a really big goal of the release, as well as getting it to feel more comfortable for those of you who are familiar with using, say, Visual Studio from on Windows. We've got a number of developers that come in, you've got some history working with Visual Studio, and we want you to be able to take the knowledge you may have from the past to go ahead and bring it into Visual Studio for Mac and find your ways around. So I have a few things I'll give you a demo of there of the changes we made along those lines. As well as another big thing that we announced this week is our future plans for support of the M1 processor from Apple running the IDE natively on M1 processor. So this is Apple's ARM64 processor if you weren't familiar. And we're going to do this, and I love this part, kind of a geeky detail of moving the IDE to running on top of .NET 6 CLR, the common language runtime itself, which will also bring a number of improvements to the IDE for things like low-level performance of our file operations, things like working with file system watchers that are used across the IDE. So that combined with our new front end of the IDE makes for a really good release for us around these improvements on long-standing issues we've had with performance. So we've got a blog post that I put out that has some details of our findings working on the M1 support and what's coming up there soon. We don't have the release ready yet that I'm going to demo right now. But keep an eye out on our blog going forward to see when that M1 processor support comes out. So let's go ahead and dive on into the IDE. And today I'm going to take you through some of those things I just mentioned, the new stuff that we're working on. So here you're looking at the Visual Studio 2022 for Mac IDE. And right away, if you've used prior versions, you might notice a few things. Our status messaging has moved from the window title on down to the bottom of the IDE. And you'll see this when I do things like go to run my project, which we'll do right now. Status messaging moves down towards the bottom. The tabs have a more modern macOS feel, as well as a Visual Studio kind of a feel to them. And if you weren't familiar with Visual Studio for Mac, there's three major types of projects you can work on. There's this case, I'm working on a .NET project. This one I believe is .NET 5. The IDE supports building apps for the web and the console with .NET Core 3.1, .NET 5, and now .NET 6, as well as building out mobile applications using the traditional Xamarin project. And MAUI support will be coming soon. It's not in the build yet, but if you're looking for .NET 6 and MAUI support, stay tuned on the blog. There'll be updates after the calendar year to support that. And then finally, if you're a game developer for Unity, you can go and edit your scripts in VS for Mac and be able to edit and debug those in the IDE, moving back and forth from Unity. That's all supported in this preview release. So what I'm demoing right now is a sample application we've had for a bit that is like an online marketplace. And in here, I can add something to my cart. And I was looking at a bug that was going on in here that we can just troubleshoot together. This is where if I remove, I can remove an item from my cart by changing the quantity to 0, and I click this update button, and it's supposed to go away, but it's not going away. So let's go back to Visual Studio for Mac, and we'll troubleshoot this and see what's going on there. Now, right now, we're in a debug mode. I am, for the time being, we're going to stay in here, actually. And I know that the code I want to look at is in this piece of the application called the basket service. And if I use the search bar up in the IDE, I can search for basket service. And this bar, it searches both files, types, and members in your code, as well as commands in the IDE, menu items. In this case, I'm going to pick into the basket service class. And I know that what I want to work on is a method that's called set quantities. I got this far in my debugging previously and then had to stop here. So let's go ahead and set a breakpoint. And I'm switching back to the browser. We'll try this action again with the update button. And then our breakpoint gets hit. So you can, this is just to show that our native UI is up and running. All these usual features for debugging are here, the ability to come in and work with your locals window, the watches window. I could explore items inline here and take a look at this collection, drill into the different items. All the tools you're used to using for debugging are up and running in this preview. And I can actually see if I look down, I had a note to myself that I just forgot about was to actually implement this remove item functionality. So I'm going to stop debugging and we'll just write some code real quick. So the first thing I need to do, I know that there's this basket object and I need to call a remove empty items method on this. So here's our IntelliSense list. And it lets me filter through options like members of the types of methods, properties. If I click on remove empty items, I can just type the semicolon now and it will auto close the parentheses because it's got no parameters to that method and finish off the line. This is a change that came in, I think, in the past few releases, just a nice little shortcut. And then there's one more step in here with this basket repository where I need to call this update async method, which takes that basket as a member of it. So you can see some tooltips popping up here to show us ways to work with this code. And let's save that. So if I had implemented some unit tests for this piece of the code, which I did not, but if I did, I could go into our tests window right now and be able to take these and run the unit tests. There's a test results window that'll come up. And let me debug that. In this case, I did not have unit tests for this, which would have been a good practice. So we'll go ahead and run the project and just see if it's fixed in the web browser. So one other little item of note in here while this is running, you might have noticed the menu items in the IDE are different if you've been with us for a while with Visual Studio for Mac. So this is one of those steps to make it feel more like Visual Studio, make it easier to bring what you're familiar with from Visual Studio with you into Visual Studio for Mac. So we've got a Git menu now, project, build, debug, have items that you might be familiar with from working in other Visual Studio products, including a quick watch window, which has been a request we've heard from a number of customers. If you were stopped at a breakpoint now, I could fire up quick watch. Okay, so now let's double check to see that this is fixed for us. We'll go in, we'll add another item to the basket and see if we can go ahead and remove this. I drop the count and now I hit update. Yay, now our item is fixed and bug is done. So next step would be let's commit this to source control. So I showed you some of our new menus a moment ago with the IDE. Now if we go over here to the Git Changes window, this is another big new feature that we're bringing in. So in Visual Studio, there's been a number of improvements over on Windows to the Git experience over the past few years. And so we're beginning to start bringing these items into Visual Studio for Mac. So the Git Changes is one of the first real big examples of that work. So here I can come in and I could review changes that have been made, say, to this CS proj. I could compare it with what's up in Git, kind of see what edits have been made. I could take a look at the history of any changes made to the file. In this case, I've been working in this one service for a bit. So let's go find the basket service we were just working on. And I could take a look at history of changes that were made to see when that to-do note got left. Was it something I forgot? Did it come somewhere else? I could come through here and browse and get a summary of changes that were made to with historic edits to this file. Or as a final step, I can come and just take the items that I want and say that this list looks good. I want to move the basket service up. I can stage the change. And now I could type in a commit message, push it up to the server or pull the next set down and go from there. So this, I mentioned, is one of the first steps in the Git tooling we're working on. We're also working toward adding in a Git branch selector. So it's not in the builds you're using yet, but it's another one to keep an eye on that we will have before we release. The plan is to release Visual Studio 2022 for Mac after the new calendar year. So we're working on still a few finishing details, and a Git branch selector will be one of those. So let's go back to the source code for a moment, which is a big area a lot of us spend our days. And I want to call your attention to the light bulbs that were coming out. Now, you may already be familiar with the light bulbs, but if not, let me explain how these work. So when I'm on a line of code, like I am here, you may see a light bulb pop up. And this is the IDE telling you that there's a change you should make to your code, either to meet the code formatting requirements of your code base or to deal with something, say it's identified in .NET 6, is like this is a built-in thing that you should do with your source code. Look for the light bulbs as those strong suggestions to make changes. There are other types, such as a screwdriver icon that shows up, and this will give you suggestions for improvements that are maybe nice to have, or you could make them, but not a strong suggestion. In this case, if we come back up, I'll click on the light bulb that showed up. And what you're seeing here is our new quick fix dialog. So we have changed this up, brought back a preview pane to show you what will happen if you select on the left side one of these suggested improvements to your code. On the right side, it shows you what that, say, refactoring will do to your code base. And one of our themes in the work that we're doing in the IDE is to improve accessibility. And this was one of the drivers for this new UI. The previous solution wasn't very accessible for working through items. So while we revisited making it into a more accessible UI, we also worked on some improvements for making it easier to quickly get to a refactoring you want to apply. So for example, right now I can hit Option Enter. Brings up that list. I could say that I actually want to invert the if. I can type a filter in, and then I can just hit Enter and apply that change to my code. So I just mentioned accessibility. That is another really big piece of the native macOS UI work that we've got going on. So previously, there were portions of the UI that you couldn't really get into well with Apple's built-in accessibility tools like VoiceOver, the text-to-speech service that they provide. Now that we're all native UI, everything can be accessed using those tools. So if I were to come in here to the system preferences and go into the accessibility settings, I can start using some options like VoiceOver to be able to navigate through my IDE. Or I can go in and we actually now have a new high contrast themes available, both the dark and the light themes of the IDE. So now you've got, if we go back, and I actually really like the way this looks, that I almost was thinking of making it my daily color theme. These stronger strokes around borders, higher contrast, kind of makes it pop more. And likewise, this applies if we go to light mode. So this is always a fun, easy way to see that it's a native UI for the IDE, is I can change the option now at the system level, and Mac and Visual Studio for Mac will respect the system settings and adapt to the light or the dark theme as you choose. Or you could choose the auto theme with Mac OS, which will go light during the daytime, dark at nighttime. This change, I'm gonna go back to dark, and we'll turn back off the high contrast mode. Now let's talk preferences for a moment. And this is where you could go if you wanted to actually choose a different theme for the IDE. You could go light if you prefer other apps and the OS to be light, but maybe the OS is a dark theme. Or you could mix it up, or in this case, choose the default, which is auto, to adapt to the OS settings. But preferences is a fun screen. I always like to go in here on any new app I'm trying out. It's a fun area to look and see what are some of the options you might be able to turn on in the product you're working with. It's also one of the best examples of our native UI work, because this was one of those places in the IDE that everything was this other UI toolkit I mentioned. So here, all of the controls are now native macOS UI. There's a full refresh of these screens. So there's more of these screens we're still working on. They aren't all in the preview 3 release just yet, but we're rolling out more and more of these. And so by the time we hit our general release next year, we'll have all the preferences brought over, as well as a few sprinklings of some new options as well that we'll be bringing in over time. So let's see, we've just covered a bunch, native UI of the product, some new features from Windows like the Git Changes window, and mentioned .NET 6 and C# 10. I'd mentioned earlier, but I want to hit on it again about what's coming soon with us running the IDE on the .NET 6 common language runtime, so the CLR. That, to users of the IDE, will have some nice improvements for things like as you work with the file system and make some changes, maybe through Git, the IDE should be able to be more responsive in picking those up because we've got a whole new low-level like I/O stack for the IDE. So those are things that are harder to demo, but that you'll see coming on as we change up this last lower layer of the IDE and get it on .NET CLR. One last mention. I mentioned the refactoring a little bit. Another kind of fun one in here is with C# 10 in a project, there's a few new refactorings too. We'll have more in our release notes, but for example, I could come in here now, start converting my project over to C# 10 and use this new refactoring to move my namespace to be file scoped. We got a number of other nice things like that across the IDE coming in, more and more refactoring. So the list keeps growing. Check our release notes to see more examples of some of the ones available in the IDE these days. Finally, I mentioned windowing changes. One other thing coming soon is the ability to more easily move around your tool windows. So the build I'm running right now doesn't have some of this in, but we're working to improve the drag and drop experience for your tool windows. Much like Visual Studio gives you a spot you can drop your window and be able to dock, say, the Git changes on the right side or the left side of the IDE, that's a spot you'll see us improving. And in this build here, you're able to come in and work with document groups. So I could say a new vertical document group and be able to look at two documents side by side, move those back. And it's another example of where we're adopting some similar terminology from Visual Studio where there's support for document groups. So with that, I'll just leave with some more information on where to get more details. We put out a blog post about the Preview 3 release, highlighting the items I mentioned here today, and talking a bit about what's next with running natively on the M1 processor, as well as our Git branch selector. You can go out to the blog post, download the release now, and if you want to stay up with us too, we're working on a preview newsletter. So you can join in and just get updates directly from the team when we put out a new preview release and what are the new features we've introduced, giving you some opportunities to provide some more feedback to us, things like those. So please go ahead, take a look, go check it out, and let us know what you think. Anytime, go into the IDE, you can use the help menu, choose report a problem, share, you know, problems you run into. And yeah, we thrive on your feedback. So the more of that we can get in these early days of previews, the better. So in closing, again, this release we'll be looking at generally available. The final release of 2022 for Mac will be after the new year. And Preview 3 available now, and look for an update soon with that M1 native support. So thanks so much for joining me today. Hope you do well, and happy coding.